there's no other train in sight. I thought this was a busy station. There's only me here. This game can be confusing. So, a couple of other trains have turned up. But on the different line. Looks like everybody else can go apart from me. I'm not sure what to make of all this. The scenario said, you must ensure your passengers arrive at Ealing Broadway on time. And then it makes you sit at Reading for a, like an hour. I feel like I should get out and go and talk to somebody and say, excuse me, what's going on? Why is this red light broken? Everything's on red. This makes no sense. Has the game died? Everything's on red. That can't be right. How can everything, how can all this be on red as well? Doesn't make much sense. Finally, finally it's gone yellow. I sat here for about 8 minutes. 8 minutes I think I sat here. And it finally went yellow. I have no idea what that was all about. Wow. I don't think I've ever driven a scenario in this game where a light has stayed on that long. What on earth happened? Look, everything is on red. Has there been a catastrophe ahead? Has like a meteor hit the track? Hang on a minute. Are we about to go red again? I have no idea which line we're about to switch onto. No, we're going straight on, I believe. No, we're not. We're going this way. That's for that track. I'm not sure what ours says. That's where we're going. So basically, we're waiting for those trains to go through so that we could get onto this track. That's what the delay was. It seemed a little bit excessive, though, to me. Is that for us? Is that all red light? Or is that their red light? It's got to be their red light, surely. It's on that side. It can't be ours. Well, the emergency brakes didn't come on, so that's a good sign. Should we get up to line speed? And you don't even toot back, you scumbags. Trying to see what's down there. I can see red lights, but I don't think they're ours. This is such a bizarre setup. I feel like I really want to look around this scenery right now, but I'm too afraid to do it. There's quite a lot of weird stuff going on. Let's get up to line speed. I tell you what, if you're doing this in career mode, imagine trying to get this there on time, given everything that just happened. Okay, let's get up to line speed now. I think, and I hope, that's the end of the weirdness. Reading is apparently a very strange place. Especially if you're a train driver. We're all green now. Oh! That is so weird. Sorry if I frightened you. I'm not really. That is so bizarre. It's the love way you fly down the middle of a train and everybody just sat there. The other thing is, why is everybody else's train got so many people on board? I sit in the back of the mine and look at it. There's not even a person sat here reading a paper. they could, you know what it is? They just couldn't be bothered to do it. They couldn't be bothered to model the people in the train, so they just go, there you go, it's empty carriage. Yeah, if you jump outside, start working your way along, maybe have a look that way. Oh, that one's empty. Look at that. That's full of people. That's full of people, and so on and so forth. So basically what we're saying is, the only one that I got into was the one right at the back here, which had... Oh, come on, camera. Okay. Sorry about that. There's one back here which has absolutely nobody in it. That one. That is the carriage I get into when I do that. It must be. It won't let you swing inside your own train, look. So I want to go and talk to Mr. Squishy Head Bar, because he really has got a deformed head. And I think he must have really interesting things to say. We're blasting through here. Look at this. 12 miles down to Slough. I don't even know what station that was, actually. Oh, look, there's another squishy head. This is why they don't do it. Now, she looks normal. We could go and talk to her. She's like the only normal person on the train. So there's one engine at the back here, which is all painted up for red. I'm not even sure what that means. And then the train at the front has a different skin on it. But otherwise, I think it's the same engine. So we're... Oh, I think, you know what they need? They need a compass in here. Because I reckon at the moment, we must be almost heading east now. Where's the sun? What time of morning? It's midday. Looking by the sun, it's just up here. So it rises in the east. It would have risen over there somewhere. So I reckon we're probably going east, southeast. But it'd be fantastic if they put a compass in here. You don't really need one on a train, obviously. But just for interest. Oh, max speed to 125. Marker right, tail right, marker centre. None of these buttons work. Let's fly through the train again. Oh my god! Best part of the game. Let's zoom right out and have a look at the scenery. Wonderful British countryside. With a random factory. And look at that guy there, look at this. He just literally just planted in the middle of a field. He's got no path or driveway or anything. He's just, his house is in the middle of grass. That must be so inconvenient. Imagine when it rains, get to your door and your feet are covered in mud. What does all that say? You can't read it. They deliberately made it so that you can't read it. Eight miles to Slough, and then it's on to Ealing Broadway. So we're on the outskirts of Slough now, aren't we? Not far away. Like I say, Slough is not the best place on earth. I'm being kind. I could play Duck Under the Bridge, couldn't I? Look at this. See how long I can leave it before I duck under the bridge. Might have to play Duck Under the Lights. You could entertain yourself with the camera. You should get points for doing this, look. So this is Slough, is it? Or the outskirts. Actually, what's 6 miles away from Slough? Maidenhead, possibly. This could... be... is it Maidenhead? Would it be Maidenhead? I'm not sure. Maidenhead is very, very built up, though. So it could be. Oh, God. Scenic viewing. Emergency brake engaged. So there's only one way. If you play this game, career mode, you are forced to sit in the cockpit. You can't go into a third person and look around. Because if you do, this is what happens. And there's nothing you can do. You can't adjust the brake until the train has stopped now. All that because I didn't acknowledge a yellow light. Oh well, at least I get to sit on the train. Have a look at the scenery. While we slowly grind to a halt. But yeah, if you're playing in career mode, you're going to have to sit here just so that you can hear the AWS. I suppose you could do this and press Q all the time. But then you wouldn't see the yellow signal either, so you can't win no matter what you do. Right, let's get the brake released. All the passengers were just wondering what the hell is going on. All the passengers going, hey! Seven miles to Slough. Could have done without that. Because this thing takes quite a while to get up to speed. It's a hell of a lot of mass going on here. I wonder what river that is, actually. What's the river just outside of Slough? Does anybody know? The textures on this, on the landscaping here are a bit. See the stretching. They need a different texture though. They just basically use the same texture and deformed the surface and it's just stretched it. Whoa! I just went under the bridge. This is one straight bit of track. I suppose I better stay in the cockpit and look out for AWS. Maybe shout abuse at the passengers. Back out a bit. Have a look round. I've never actually tried to use the world editor in this game. If I had the time in my life, I'd have a play with it to see what you can do. If you've had the time, you could basically build your own scenarios in this game. A lot of people do. It takes a lot of time to lay out all this stuff. But, you know, with things like Google Maps, make it a lot easier to get fairly accurate track. Of course, the problem is you've got a toolbox of models like the buildings and stuff, and if you see something like you drove past, I don't know, let's say you saw Big Ben, you'd have to model Big Ben yourself to put it in because it wouldn't come in the game. So then you've got to get into 3D modeling and that takes its own time. Oh god, this is not good. We're doing 80 miles per hour and a double yellow just hit us. Oh dear, oh dear, oh dear. And it's flashing as well. I'm not exactly sure what a flashing one means. Sure that wasn't in the rail manual. I'm just going to cruise at like 40 or something. What does flashing mean? I thought they were all static lighting. There's a lot of crazy things happening in this thing. So I'm going to lose points for emergency brakes. I'm going to lose points probably for being late, even though it's not really giving me a time to get there. It did say don't let anybody be late, but it didn't say, like the Slough, it doesn't say what time I'm supposed to be there. It just says ETA. Oh, this is quite cool. bridge as well. Fabulous. Right. Can anybody see? No, it's gone. Look, it's not flashing anymore, and I really don't understand what the difference is, but I did see a sign though. What does that say? West Side Block. What's West Side Block? Does anybody know? So many buildings. Whoa, AWS. Glad I jumped back in the cockpit. Okay, it's gone back to green. There must be a line speed limit coming in here. It's not worth accelerating. That's about to kill my speed. Slough ahead. Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Slough. Yeah, many years ago bought a car from Slough for my wife. That was my first ever visit to Slough. Bought a, it was like a Volvo, I think. There's only, it wasn't much, it was about £700 or something. It wasn't that expensive. It was basically, I think that was the first, yeah, I'm sure it was the first time we ever got a second car. And she needed a second car, basically, so we just got a cheap Volvo. It was fine for a few years. Did its job, but then it kind of eventually started to become more expensive than it was worth. Fixing it up all the time. And then it started to smell of petrol inside, which is never a good sign for a car, is it really? So we got shut of it. Right, distance 0.3 of a mile. 36 miles per hour. We're coming in hot. £30 per hour as we enter the platform. Flashing yellows again. Nobody knows why. Possibly left the braking too late. But it depends how good this train is right now. Can't see the back of my train. Am I on the platform? Right, hang on a minute. The back of my train is not on the platform. That is kind of odd. I'm going to nudge forward a little bit, but there's no way we're going to get all of this thing on, though. That's impossible. This platform's not long enough for this thing. It's almost like this train and this scenario were not built for each other. Why is that flashing again? What does that mean? I need to look that up. I keep seeing a lot of this homework sign on the left here. Massive 20% off. All in store. I'm gonna use the entire length of this platform as best as I can. But sadly, some people are not. Well, I say sadly, I'm actually doing people a favour. They won't be able to get off at Slough, and that isn't a bad thing. But if you were on the back onto three carriages, you have no chance of getting off my train. That's what we're saying. Welcome to Slough. You're gonna love it. Okay. We're almost ready for the off, although that's flashing a different combination of yellow flashes going on now. I think we better proceed with caution. There's obviously something going on ahead. The signalling's been kind of weird all the way through, to be honest. We'll get up to about 25 or something and then see what the next set of signals are showing. It must mean some kind of caution if it's flashing. It must be worse than not flashing. Flashing lights generally mean bad things, don't they? That's the view I'm taking. You never see a flashing light and it's kind of a, ooh, this is all good. This is fine. Don't worry about this flashing light. It's always a case of, no, 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 be careful, caution, mayday. It's a weird place for a van. Are we changing track or are we staying on this one? We are staying on this one. Okay, so let's just keep our eye out on the signal. Final destination coming up, Ealing Broadway, 12.53 miles. Oh, look at this on the left. Forklift simulator. Where are the zombies, dude? You need to get zombies in there. It's more fun with zombies. Once you don't get stuck on scenery like I did. Uh-oh. It's happened again. I'm looking at the forklift and the AWS trips the emergency brakes. Ah! Just because I didn't press the Q key. See, if I had my head stuck out the window, I would definitely hear that, wouldn't I? That's the annoying thing. I would definitely hear the AWS going off with my head out the window. There's no doubt about it. Take this opportunity to admire the wonderful floating scenery over here. Look at that. Look at those logs being levitated. That's quite impressive. I've never... And the trees as well. Somebody forgot to set the ground level properly. That is quite amusing. Everything's just floating. It's like the ground level's here, and then they deformed the ground downwards and forgot to move all the scenery. Because they thought you wouldn't notice as you were flying past in your train. Shortcuts, people. Shortcuts. Okay, there's a track speed of 40 coming up, so I'm just going to cruise. There's also a lot going on this line. I think everybody's going to Wembley or something. This cup final's causing absolute chaos. Don't toot back. It's fine. There's another train coming down here. Is that stationary or not? Oh God, this can't be right, this can't be right. Are you kidding me? If this doesn't change track, it's doomsday. Ooh, I have to say I was slightly worried right there. 40 miles an hour and there's no way we're gonna stop. That must have been more scary for you, my friend. Because I'm a lot heavier than you are. And you'd have come off worst, I reckon. Crikey. If somebody didn't get that signal right, people would die. I mean, there's no messing about that. You don't get that signal right and people die. Oh, we can do two of our favourite things in the world. First thing being... Ah! And the second thing being, we even get to fly under a bridge at the same time. Right, I'm going to speed it up, I think, and the speed limit's been lifted, but I'm conscious of the plethora of yellow lights. I've been caught out with an emergency brake, what, three times? That's poor, man, that's poor. Hello, you hopeless cloned people. It's a pity you can't stick your hand out and just kind of high-five them as you go past 50 miles an hour. Right, let's get up to line speed because the signals are now green. Hopefully that means we get a move on. Ealing Broadway, 10 miles. Well, I thought that car was... You see that car up there? I thought that car was driving across the field. You know, normally when I go on trains, it's because I'm commuting. It's just for work. I hardly ever go on trains for pleasure. And I think I should. I think I should just take, you know, fun days out on trains. Especially on steam trains. Go down to Devon and Cornwall. In fact, I'm going down to Devon this year in summer, so... maybe I should find a nice steam train and book myself onto that. In fact, I think I'm going to do that. Heck, if I took my video camera, I could video it, couldn't I? Make a video. Day out on a steam train. That'd be awesome, actually. I should probably look into that. Fly anywhere in Europe. Hang on, hang on, hang on. Last minute. Whoa! And back up again. I like this. We need to name this game. Bridge ducking or something. That never gets boring. Right, let's see how much scenery we can avoid before we hit the emergency brake, shall we? Oh, that truck's floating. The back of that truck's floating. These map guys need to pay attention. How many trucks have you got in there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 white trucks. The hell? I don't even know where we are. Actually, what is that? I can't read it. It goes past too quickly. See, it's just... can we move? How do we move? There we go. That's how we can do it. West Drayton. So right now my train is probably hitting the AWS on me. So if I press 8 and then zoom up ahead. Never actually done this before. We can actually wait for our own train to come past. Just wait by the side of the road. Here it comes. Whee! How cool's that? That is good, being able to do that. You can't do that in real life, that's for sure. Looks like the sun's kind of going in a bit, and... I don't know, it's still fairly sunny. It's definitely getting more and more built up, though. I'm getting more and more concerned about signal lighting, such as that one right there. Look at that. My spidey senses tingled. I knew it. Built up area. Third person camera. What's the game gonna do? Yep. Oh, uh-oh. It looks like a red light as well. That looks like a red light. That's alright, that's on the other side. Single yellow, that's fine, we can deal with that. I'm not sure what speed to be doing at this point, to be honest. I suppose it needs to be... you know, if we see a single yellow, we need to get ready to stop. If it's a double yellow, we do need to stop, basically. Or about the next one could be a red. It's the rules of the track. Now, that was an ADBS, but I can't see the light that goes with it. It's kind of weird. I can see yellow down there. Just about. I think I'm just going to cruise at this speed. Ooh, massive car park. But why? They should put a supermarket there. That's gone green. Which is good. It means I can shift up to about 70 now, I reckon. 3.69 miles. Can't wait to see my score. I'm going to get so many penalties. Those emergency brakes alone. Speeding, though, tends to be the one that kills your points more than anything. And I did speed a bit, but the problem with speeding is it just kind of burns your score. It just penalises until you get under the speed limit. And it can be brutal. The point deductions compared to just a simple emergency brake. Whoa. Surely that's going to break the track. That's ridiculous. 70 miles an hour through that. Outrageous. That should have been like 40 or something. Can we fly through your train? Aww. Not in this mode. In this camera. And we are approaching Ealing Broadway. I know very little about Ealing Broadway, if I'm honest with you. I do know that the Central Line tube station goes there, I think. I remember seeing the Central Line listed as a destination. 2.5 miles. Let's pick up a little bit of speed. One day they'll reply. One day. Oh, this is a nice bridge. I like this. I do like big, nice bridges. They do look rather cool. We've got a track speed of 80, but we're only 1.5 miles away, which makes me think we should just be cruising in now. So apparently the crew's going to change and somebody else is going to take them to Wembley. Which is really disappointing because I would have liked to have taken them to Wembley. But I'll tell you why we're not. Because they couldn't be bothered to model Wembley and Wembley Station. That's why not. Right, 0.8. Let's start hitting the brakes at this point, I think. We are definitely coming in hot this time. See if we can make a good final stop. 50 miles per hour with 0.5 mile left. I think it should be fine. We can stop that. I don't see that as a problem. Oh, look at this. I could be playing. What did we call it? It's not the same at such low speeds, though, is it? Oh, hang on. Crap. I need to brake. What am I doing? I'm too busy playing games with the camera and forgetting to actually stop at the station. That's never a good idea. Okay, let's whack on some more brakes now. Is this our final destination? I think it is. It is. Ealing Broadway 4. It's quite difficult judging the braking. I think that's not a bad effort, if I'm honest. That's not a bad effort at all. It's pretty good, actually. Quite happy with that. Maybe even the back of the train is on the track as well. Who knows? It is. Look at that. Everybody can get off at this station. Awesome. Well, I think that was quite fun. That's Ealing Broadway. That is the final destination. We'll find out in a minute how many points I've managed to lose. Quite a few, I imagine. Three emergency stops. There was one. What was that? Modern Drive, you arrived at Ealing Broadway on time. Really? I don't think so. What have we got here? Penalty brake applied 10 times. Speeding twice. Penalty brake applied 10 times. That was me going over 80% probably. Signal passed at danger twice. That was me trying to go through the signal, getting all very confused. But it didn't break my points down like career mode. Distance travel 57.6 miles in 1 hour and 5 minutes. Class 67 EWS Executive. That has completed Foot X scenario. I hope you enjoyed that journey. A couple of cock-ups on my part. Also some confusion. But it was otherwise, it was a nice sunny journey through Oxfordshire. Hope you enjoyed the video. Please remember to give a thumbs up if you did. Until the next train video, guys, take care and happy training.